Much of what Arkansas has done is unprecedented. In the modern history of the U.S. death penalty, no one has attempted to carry out so many executions in such a short period of time, and no one has ever attempted to set up an execution schedule based around what has been described as an artificial kill-by date, which is the date that the drug expired. People expect that if an execution is going to happen, it's done in a more dignified way based on the needs of the criminal justice system. And when a drug expires, doesn't seem to be a principled basis for scheduling 8 executions.
When it comes to this drug, midazolam, if I'm saying that right, there not only is there a shortage of it, apparently, but there were doubts about how effective it was anyway. Is that right?
Yeah, there's actually not a shortage in the sense that that the drug is unavailable to the public. Midazolam is used in a lot of medical procedures, typically non-invasive, non-painful procedures. When it's used in tooth extractions, you have an anesthetic that is used so that the person doesn't feel pain. And the problem for using a drug like midazolam in a 3-drug lethal injection is it's not an anesthetic. The first drug, which is what midazolam is supposed to make the prisoner unconscious so that he or she doesn't feel the pain from potassium chloride, which has been described as being like chemically burned at the stake, or from the second drug, the vecuronium bromide, which paralyzes your muscles and slowly suffocates you. Midazolam can't do that, and that's why it's always inappropriate to be used in executions.
Yeah, and when I meant harder to get, I meant by states wanting to use it for executions. It is getting harder in that regard, right?
That's correct. Yeah. That's correct. The American pharmaceutical companies, to a man or to a company, have said they do not want their medicines used in carrying out executions. They say we've got a medical mission, and that mission is to save lives and promote health, not to take lives. So they have said we're not going to knowingly sell these drugs to prisons if they're going to be used in executions.
And the interesting thing, too, is when states are looking for other sources for this drug, Europe, for example, trying to choke off supply too, because the EU doesn't have the death penalty and doesn't want to enable other nations, so that's cut off another supply, right?
That's right. Europe says very clearly that the death penalty is a violation of human rights, and it has adopted, the European Union has adopted human rights export regulations that prohibit selling medicines to the United States or any other state or any other country for use in executions.
And now this leaves us in a situation where, I mean, the death penalty is still legal in many U.S. states. What are states that want to carry out executions doing to get around these issues?
Well, there are a variety of things. Some of the states are doing what Arkansas did, which is to misrepresent what they're going to use the medicines for and essentially get the drugs under false pretenses. They're not likely to be able to do that again. So what other states have done is change which drugs they use, go to what are called compounding pharmacies, these small pharmacies that put together individual groups of drugs, or they've thought about changing the method of execution. Still others are doing nothing because they're satisfied not executing anybody, and some other states have considered abolition. We've seen that whole range of things as part of the state's responses.
Which actually brings me to the next question I wanted to ask you, and that is, despite what we've seen in Arkansas, which just seems incredibly brutal, just basically rushing through executions, is in general the U.S. stepping back a little bit from executions? You do have some states outlawing it, others not using it quite so much. Is there a step back from it?
Yeah, historically, we've seen that over the last 20 years, there's been a significant decline in the use of the death penalty in the United States. Public support for the death penalty has declined tremendously. The number of executions has continued to decline. And I think the most telling number is the number of new death sentences. Last year, there were 30 new death sentences as compared to 315 in 1996, which means one new death sentence for every 10 and a half death sentences that were imposed 20 years ago.
Why do you think that is very quickly?
I'm sorry?
Why do you think that is very quickly?
I think it's a range of things, everything from innocence to cost to the reduction in the number of homicides in the United States. But mostly it's that the public has lost faith in the death penalty and doesn't believe that it contributes to public safety, believes it costs too much and does too little, and they are worried about making mistakes. We had our 158th death row exoneration just last week, And people don't want to see innocent people executed. And they don't want to see their states breaking the law in order to try to carry out the law.